What is up? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you are watching this video. If you are new here, thank you so much for clicking on this video. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you guys for being so patient with me because I have not made a video in like 2 or 3 months now. So today's just gonna be a little bit of a vlog slash life update. I have some really exciting stuff to talk to you about, specifically this jewelry, but I'm about to jump into my morning yoga flow and then make some coffee and I will sit down and chit chat with you guys and share my day. But I hope you guys enjoy this video. That I love so much. I guess this really isn't my kitchen, it's like the dining area, but I love it so much. I'm gonna give you guys an apartment tour just quickly later because not everything's in here. Once I have everything, I will be doing a full apartment tour video so I can like link everything for you guys. But I got this beautiful table on Facebook Marketplace for $100 and I love it. It really ties this room in together. And I just love sitting here in the morning. It just makes me so happy. So I'm just really excited for this whole year and being able to have more free time and the flexibility to just share what I want with you guys and not have to worry about school assignments or just stuff like that. So what I really wanted to talk to you guys about while I sit here and drink my coffee is my beautiful new jewelry. I am wearing earrings for like the first time in years. I got my middle helix pierced on this side and my upper helix or cartilage pierced on that side, and I can't switch them out yet, so they're just the little titanium studs. So Ana Luisa reached out to me a little bit ago and I was on the trip, and so we waited until July to circle back to it, but they sent me these pieces. They're absolutely beautiful, and the thing that I loved the most about this company when they first reached out to me and I was doing a little bit of my own research on their website is that they are a very sustainable brand. The metals that they use are very sustainable. They don't tarnish. They're very high quality, so that you're not going to buy something, wear it for a little bit, and then get rid of it because it's turning your neck green or it's rusting or tarnishing or anything like that. These are going to keep well for a long time, which I absolutely love. Something that I'm really, really working on, especially when furnishing my apartment and just purchasing new things for myself in general, is trying to be more sustainable, trying to reuse what somebody else has already used, or trying to purchase from brands that are really doing something to protect the environment. That is something that has become very near and dear to my heart, especially after the little road trip we did out west. There's just so much beauty in this world, and I really want to do my part to protect and conserve and just be a smarter consumer and not buying things that are so fast fashion or fast jewelry, I guess. But I just really love that these are going to last me so long, and they're just such beautiful, simple, classic pieces that I feel go with like everything that I wear, whether it's gym clothes or a little bit more fancy. I'm just really loving these. The necklace that I'm currently wearing is the Sylvia set, which I absolutely love. It's a little half moon necklace and then a little gold plate. I just think it's absolutely adorable. I've been wearing this every single day. I really love it. Currently, I'm just wearing this little bandeau top, but I think I'm gonna put on like a high-necked black top, because when I wear these necklaces, I've been trying to wear things that are a little bit more up higher on my neck because it really makes these pop. They just look so cute. So when I change later, I will obviously show you. But I also have on the Riviera earrings. I don't know if you guys can see that. Like I said, I'm gonna throw up some closer clips. Also, I'm looking a little bit oily, but I just put on my moisturizer, so my face is just still like a little bit wet. Don't be alarmed. Anyways, back to the jewelry. I'm literally loving these. These earrings are so cute. I'm not somebody who's really into like hoop earrings or dangly earrings because I always feel like they're gonna get caught on things, but I've been wearing with these, and honestly last week I fell asleep with these in and they did not bother me once while I was sleeping. They don't bother me during the day. My hair doesn't get caught in them. They're not heavy. I just think that they're so cute, and they're like a hoop with a little dangly piece, which I think is absolutely adorable. If you guys couldn't tell, I'm not like an expert on jewelry because I don't know what any of the technical terms are. And I really was drawn to these pieces and this earring as well. I don't know if you guys can see, but it's got like a little sun on it. I was really drawn to these pieces because I am a Cancer sun and a Cancer moon, and those are two things that I very strongly identify as or with, whatever you'd like to say. And I just like love moon and sun jewelry or pieces in your house or clothing or anything like that. So when I saw these on the website, I was like, yes, that is very right in my alley. These will match other things I wear. They really match my vibe, just what I like to put on and what I think looks cute on me. As far as pricing goes, because I know that cute little dainty jewelry like this can be a little bit more expensive just because it's on trend these days. But the other thing that I love about Ana Luisa is everything is fairly affordable. Start at about $39 and then increase in price. How sustainable the brand is, the pricing is fantastic. Like I said, this necklace is $99 and these earrings are $75, but they are truly like luxury pieces without the luxury price markup, which I think is so fantastic. I would definitely recommend checking out these pieces if you are at all interested. My camera ran out of memory, so I had to go delete a couple things. But back to what I was saying, if you guys are interested in checking out any of their pieces, I do have a link with them. It'll be the first one down in my description box, and I also have a code that will get you 10% off. It is NatalieB10. I will put that down below as well, but I just absolutely love their pieces. I think they're so cute, and once I get changed later, I will show you guys how I'm styling them, and yeah, I just absolutely love them, and I'm so happy I was able to collab with them on this video. But I'm going to finish drinking my coffee and I have a phone call with my manager at Gymshark, and then I'm going to change and get ready for the day. So I will check back in with you guys then. Okay guys, I have finished my coffee. I did a little bit of computer work, just answering some emails and all of that good stuff. And now I'm on my way, well, I'm about to walk out the door to go to my sugaring appointment. And I'm super excited because I live in walking distance now, so I don't even have to move my car. But I did change my outfit. I just want to show you guys what I have on real quick. So I'm wearing the new Vital Seamless top, which is in the color cherry brown, I think it's called. It's kind of like a purpley brown red color. I think it's super cute. And then I have on the training shorts, which I absolutely love. Mine like bunch right on my belly button, which I don't really mind too much, but they fit me everywhere else, so I didn't want to size down. But here's what I'm wearing. Obviously gonna throw a pair of shoes on, but once I get back I will give you guys a little update. And I also just want to talk about all the things going on in my head. I gotta go so I'm not late, but I'm going to take a nice little walk. It's super nice out today, not too sunny. I love this big tree that I have outside my window. But anyway, I'm gonna stop rambling so I'm not late. I will catch you guys when I'm back. So I'm back from my sugaring appointment and I've changed again because Ohio weather is really playing me lately. It was nice and cool and breezy this morning, and now it's super hot and muggy out, so I had to shut my windows and put a tank top on and turn my air on because too hot for me. Also, I need to get a drink of water, so here's your reminder to drink your water. Pause this video, go get your water, whoa, and stay hydrated, please. Okay, so I just wanted to talk a little bit about what's going on with me, not only because, I'm sorry, there's a bus outside right now. Not only is it going to be, this needs to be moved. I'm really distracted right now. Not only do I think this is going to be a little bit therapeutic for me, but also maybe beneficial to you guys if you're feeling the same way, or if you're just confused as to where I've been, what's going on with me, and what my direction is, because I've been getting so many questions about what my plan is now that I finished college. Did I get a job? Am I just doing social media? Am I trying something different? So let's just have a quick little chat about all those things, because my day has not been super exciting yet, but I want to get this video up. So I graduated in May from Ohio State. My diploma is sitting right here on my desk. Yay! I'm a college graduate, which is so weird to say. With the way that our school year ended, it just doesn't really feel like I'm done with college, but I'm in a new city, I'm doing something different, and change is good. I'm feeling really good about it. It is a little overwhelming, even though I was ready to be done with school. It's kind of just a weird thing to come to terms with, especially in the way that it happened. So yeah, anybody else out there who has graduated college this last semester, my heart is with you, because I know how confusing and just weird this time has been for literally every single one of us. Yeah, I feel for you and I hope that you're doing well, and just know that there are bigger and better things to come. And just because you didn't get to walk across stage doesn't mean that your accomplishment is any less important than every other person who has gotten to walk across stage. So that's just my little thing to say to you and also to myself, because it's still something I'm kind of grappling with at the moment. So that happened in May. I took my little trip. If you guys want to see what I did, I put a lot of it up on my Instagram. I'm not going to go on about it too long for right now because it was so amazing, and I could literally make a whole video just about how I felt about the trip, not even what we did. So there's that there. Like I said, July was kind of a wavering month for me, and today is August 4th. So my plan moving forward is to finish moving in this week. I've got my couch coming hopefully on the 6th, but we will see. She'll be here by the 10th at the latest. But once I have my couch in here, I pretty much have all my furniture and everything, and I love this place so much. I seriously might not leave after I get this couch in here. It's gonna be amazing and so comfy, and I will obviously show you guys everything that is in this apartment maybe a little bit later in this video. But once it's like fully done, I'm definitely gonna do an apartment tour video and like link everything for you and tell you what I think. And I did a lot of DIYs, so I can show you guys how I did that too. But that will be saved for another video. My plan moving forward. So my anniversary with Tristan is actually coming up at the end of this week, and we are taking a quick little camping trip up to Michigan for like 4 days next week. So I'm really excited about that. I may or may not vlog. I kind of just wanted to leave it to be our weekend together, but maybe I'll try to pull out my camera and see what he says, if he's cool with it or not. Anyways, so that's gonna be happening next week. And then I'm seriously in Cleveland like for the foreseeable, for the next year. I don't have anything planned, no trips, no traveling, no big events, nothing like that. So it's going to be a perfect time for me to just sit down, be by myself, figure out exactly what I wanna do, how I wanna go about it, the content I wanna create, the photos that I wanna do, where I wanna take my page from here, what I wanna do with my life, because I did not get an additional job. I'm not doing anything with my degree, really. My degree was in health sciences, so a lot of the stuff that I learned is really prevalent to what's going on in the world right now. It's really helping me shape my opinions and share information with you guys on social media. And I did learn a lot of valuable things from my degree, but I'm not actually going to be pursuing like a career or a job using said degree, mainly because if you get a health and rehabilitation sciences degree, you have to go to grad school. My initial plan was to go to physical therapy school, but once this whole social media thing took off for me junior year, I kind of decided that that really was not for me, at least not at the moment, and I wanted to pursue this and see just where it goes. And in the past year, it's been super great and successful, and I still feel like I'm in the very baby beginning stages of this whole thing, which is seriously so exciting for me because I kind of understand how this all works, or at least I'm learning more about it based on watching other people, working with companies, all of those good things. But my ultimate goal is to own and run my own business. Like career-wise, that's what I would like to be doing for the next 30 to 40 years of my life. I also would really like to start purchasing, investing, renting out properties like within the next 5 years, not something I'm like actively working on right at this moment. But that is what I'm planning to do. I'm just kind of gonna see where life takes me because I feel like I still have a lot to learn. And I am somebody who really puts a lot of expectations, restrictions, stuff like that on myself when it comes to like reaching my goals and figuring out what I wanna do. And it really gives me a lot of anxiety. And so something I'm really working on is just letting go, trying to find my flow, figure out what exactly I want to do for the rest of my life. Also, I'm just noticing that this box is on the ground and it's really annoying me because it looks messy, so hold on. Anyways, what I was saying, I just feel like I put a lot of expectations on myself, and it's not always the healthiest thing. So something I'm really learning how to do is just like let go, go with the flow, figure out what makes me feel good and how I can actually find something that makes me money, that I truly enjoy, that brings me so much happiness and just fulfillment. And I don't think I'm gonna figure it out the first time I try, maybe not the second or third, but I'm really optimistic in what this apartment has for me, what the rest of my life has for me. I do plan to move again next year, hopefully across the country. Please keep your fingers crossed for me because I would really love to do that. But yeah, I don't know. I don't really have all the answers. And if you would have told me I felt this way a year ago, I would have looked at you like you were crazy, because at the time I just wanted to have full direction and like know where I was going. But now I just realize that like that's what this whole life thing is about. You're supposed to be discovering yourself as you go along. And my intention for this next year is a lot of alone time and just learning to be myself, learning to be myself while I'm by myself. Something that I really learned in college and I see a lot in other people is they never really figure out who they are in college because they're so focused on the concept of having a social life, constantly being around other people. And even like when you're studying in the library, not even talking, you're just around other people. And it's really, really hard to figure out what you in yourself, deep inside of you, believe, think, want to show up in the world. It's really hard to figure that out because there's so many voices and ideas and thoughts being projected onto you. Even if somebody is not like, this is what I think and you should think it too, it's just kind of hard to have conversations with other people about what you really believe and like walk away from a conversation saying, yeah, I'm confident in what I just said, because it's a lot of other people's thoughts and opinions that you are absorbing from your environment coming back out of your mouth, and you're like, wait a second, is that really what I think? Is that really how I wanna move about my day? And I'm just really excited to have the opportunity to kind of break away from that and figure out who I am, what I wanna be, all of those things while I'm by myself, not in the presence of somebody else's influence on my life. And I don't even think I'm somebody who is constantly like listening to other people and being like, yeah, that makes sense, totally. I definitely am using like my critical thinking and asking myself like, what do I think? But it's inevitable that you do have those influences on you when other people are around, but when they're not around in your space every day, they can't have that same impact on you. So I'm just really excited for that. I hope that that goes well for me this year. As far as like business, how I'm gonna be making money, online coaching is coming. I'm like 95% of the way done, and I've been 95% of the way done since the beginning of June, but with the trip and then a weird July and just all the things going on in the world, I'm not in the right headspace to sit down and like help you guys to my fullest ability. So I'm getting back to that place. Excuse me. I've been working with Sarah for the past couple of weeks. We're finalizing everything, but she is somebody who is really pushing me to get in my best headspace before I try to do that, which I think is so helpful, because typically if I didn't have somebody to tell me like, you need to slow down and worry about yourself first, I would constantly be pouring into other people, which is great. I love that about myself, but this another thing that I really need to learn and practice is pour and fill up my own cup before I try to pour into other people's. So we're really trying to just get me situated right now. And then online coaching is coming, I promise. I will be putting out stuff on my Instagram is where you will find the main info about that and like the most up-to-date stuff. But maybe I could do like a Q&A about what that will all entail on here. If that is something you guys are interested in, let me know down below. But that is coming. I'm super excited to start out. I'm only planning to take like 10 to 12 people just so I can get my feet wet and figure everything out without trying to, or before I overload myself, get super overwhelmed. The last thing I want to do is fail you guys. So I just need to take those baby steps as you guys take those baby steps. And hopefully within the next year, this will be a massively scaled thing that I can do and bring for you guys. And I just have a lot of ideas there. I could literally talk for 15 minutes about it. And then the other thing that I am planning to do, which I'm so excited about, I actually started watching YouTube videos about like how to, but I'm going to be starting my own podcast. This is in the very idea beginning stages. I mean, I've had this idea for like a year that I wanted to do this, and I always said I would after I graduated and had the time. But I'm really excited, definitely something I am planning to pursue and start working on in this month of August into September. Hopefully my plan is to have episodes out by the end of this year, but like I said, still in the very baby stages, like I don't have any equipment, don't have a lot of knowledge on how to actually go about the logistics of creating a podcast, like sponsors, editing, all of those things. I don't even have a name yet, so if you guys have any name suggestions, you can also drop those in the comments below. But yeah, I'm just really excited. I'm really excited to try new things and just discover what works for me, what doesn't, and hopefully evolve into some form of long-term business. Not that online coaching wouldn't be a long-term business, but I would love to like sell a product of some sort or like provide a service more than just like fitness coaching. But I'm so young, but I have so much time to figure it out, and I'm just really optimistic and open to what this year has in store for me. So that's where I'm at. I just talked for 11 minutes straight. Yeah, I guess that's That's it. There's some eucalyptus right here and it smells so good. You guys need to go to Trader Joe's and get eucalyptus. This is like $3.99 and this is like half the bundle. I have the other half in my room. This guy is like super long and just kind of hanging out over here on his own. But seriously, this stuff smells so good. Okay, now that I'm done rambling, I think I'm gonna walk you guys through my apartment real quick. I will check in with you guys after I clean up to show you my apartment and then whatever else I'm doing today. Okay, bye. Thanks for listening to me talk. If you're still here, you're the best and I love you. All right, you guys, so things are cleaned up. I'm about to go pick Tristan up from work because he doesn't have his car right now. It's in the shop. I've changed again because we're gonna work out, so I'm gonna try to film some of my workout for you, but I wanna show you my apartment super duper quick. I'm gonna try to do this in like less than a minute. So the front door is over there, so that's where you walk in. We'll get there in a second, but I'm standing by the kitchen right now. I got this table and all four chairs from Facebook Marketplace for $100. Like I said, I'm gonna tell you where I got all this stuff in my next video. I just wanna show you my kitchen is in there. So we've got sink and all that, and it's not really that clean, so I'm not gonna go in there, but that's what we're looking at in there. And then you come out here, my big, beautiful living room. My favorite thing about this place is the hardwood floors. We've got my desk over here. I think I might put something on the wall right there, but I like that it faces the window, and I just put these really cool curtains up yesterday. And then I also got this trunk from Facebook Marketplace. We've got a big old lily, and then my mirror. So this is actually the same mirror that I've always had, but when I was moving it, I chipped that bottom corner. So my dad actually bought, or I think actually we had them in our house, but he had some pieces of a door frame. So he made a little DIY mirror frame for that, which I think is cute. There's my plant that I watered this morning. I need to put her back up. And then I actually got this dresser for free on the side of the road and repainted it. So that's really cool. Some random things on top there. And then this beautiful carpet that I got from Old Time Pottery. We've got my coffee table that's gonna go here once I have a couch, basket with some blankets. Like I said, there's the front door, closet, pile of my shoes because I don't have a shoe rack yet. Here's like a little linen closet that I have extra clothes and like towels and stuff in. My bathroom is literally so cute, you guys. This building was built in like the 1920s, so it's super duper old, but I've got my peach curtain up from junior year. And then here is what the actual tile looks like. This is my shower. And then this window cranks open, which is kind of crazy, but I'm up high, so nobody can like see in my window. But funny little sink. I have a straight up prison toilet, but whatever. I need to replace the toilet paper, that's why that's there. And then my sink is actually so cute. It comes out cold water and then hot water, so it's kind of funny. But anyway, that's what's going on in here. And then here is my bedroom. Big old air conditioner in there to keep it cool. I ordered a new duvet cover. It just hasn't come in yet. So this is just like my actual duvet with nothing on it. And random old pillowcases. This is gonna look completely different once I get my bedspread in. Those pillowcases are just there temporarily. As is this. I'm either going to make or paint myself a headboard on this wall. This is just there because I didn't want to leave it blank and ugly. And then this dresser is super old, not well made. I know it's really cute. I don't even remember where I got it, but it is falling apart. But I'm gonna use it for the year because it works, whatever. TV is going out in the living room. We just don't have anywhere to sit out there, so it's in here so I can watch TV. And cool little tapestry. I think I got that from Amazon a couple years ago. Hung my string lights. Trash that I need to take out. Look at how beautiful my Gymshark collection looks in here. This isn't even everything I have. I took some out because this was literally overflowing and put them in my closet, but I just wanted to put this on display because I think it looks cute. I repainted my cubes light pink. I don't even know if you guys can tell, but. And then I got these two really super cute prints in Utah on my trip. Then we've got a super duper old dirty mirror. This isn't even like streak smudges. I don't know if you guys can see this. Let's see if I can get this to focus. Anyways, it's not gonna work, but this mirror literally isn't even dirty or smudgy. Like, look. Are you serious? It's like under the glass. I need some special cleaner for this, I think. Also, I got this rug from Old Time Pottery as well. If you guys have one near you, I would definitely recommend going. It's super cheap. And then, yeah, that's from Anthropology, Facebook Marketplace. My fiddle leaf, which needs to be watered because she's looking a little sad. And then I actually got this at Target for like 25 bucks. And then a big old closet. I've got my laundry and a shoe rack in there. So yeah, I absolutely love it. I'm so excited to finish it up and actually show you guys what it is looking like once my couch is in here. My couch is gonna be so beautiful and comfy. I can't wait to take a nap on it. I'm literally so excited. But I need to go pick Tristan up from work. Gonna charge my camera battery on the way over there and then work out at his house because we've got a little home gym going there, which is super cool. I don't think I've showed you guys that yet. Tristan made a homemade squat rack and homemade plates to put on a barbell. So I'll show you that and we can check that out and I'll show you a little bit of my workout and let you know what I'm doing the rest of the day. Back home. I'm about to make dinner. It is actually like 8:30. I ended up hanging out with Tristan for a little bit and he's off to hang out with his friends. So I made my way home. Now I need to eat something. I had a little bit of his dinner, but not too much. So I'm going to make some bonza and I have one more box to unpack that I've been putting off because it's just like a bunch of scrambled bathroom stuff that I really just don't want to sort through. But that is my plan for the rest of the evening. There's a fire or siren going off somewhere. I feel so good after just kind of talking about the way I've been feeling recently. I really haven't been journaling or meditating because it just feels super unintentional. And it's almost like when you read a book and you're like, what did I just read? I feel like I keep journaling and then I'm like, what did I just even write? Or meditation just really hasn't been sticking or working for me lately, which is fine. Everything ebbs and flows. I'm in a season of change and I just have to adapt and that's totally fine. But I'm super hungry, so I'm gonna go make my pasta. But I'll check in with you guys one more time. I'm sorry this vlog really wasn't that exciting to get some workout footage, but my camera died. But yeah, I'm just having a good day. It felt really good to pull my camera out and just talk. And like I said, baby steps, slowly getting back into the swing of things, and I'm feeling good about it. So hope that you guys enjoyed, and yeah. Mama loves Mambo. Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it, shout no lay with it, wow. So I have finished cooking my dinner. I have some Italian cooking music on because I made pasta and I'm having my first glass of wine, first sip of alcohol in over a month. Not somebody who enjoys very much alcohol, but every once in a while a glass of wine really puts me in a good mood and I'm having such a good day. I thought it would be this little celebration. I bought myself some last week at Trader Joe's. And yeah, I'm going to enjoy this dinner, unpack this box, and start editing this video. So I just wanted to come on here and close this out like officially so I didn't leave this open-ended. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. It was more of a life update than it was a vlog, but hope that you enjoyed and hope that there are some more exciting vlogs in the future, because I've got a lot of exciting things in the works and I'm just really excited to be on here and share my life. So cheers to that. I hope that you guys are having a lovely day whenever you're watching this, and hope to see you back on here soon.